Welcome back. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how we generate our strategies and how we then download them as expert advisors. The first thing you'll notice is that on the right here, under my data, I have the data that we have imported from IG, from Forex Time, and from Lucas Coffee, but there is no data here from JFD. The reason for this is, if we go to our generator, the first thing under historical data we have is data source. And here you can select. So as you saw, we have IG, we have Forex Time, and we have Dukas Copy. But the very first one is MetaTrader Demo. Now MetaTrader Demo is in fact historical data from JFD. We don't need to import it because it is already in Expert Advisor Studio and it gets updated daily. So you always have the latest historical data available from JFD within Expert Advisor Studio. So let's run through how we generate our strategies. So the first thing is we go to historical data, we select our data source, we select our symbol. Now on the drop down, you'll notice that we have a number of different assets or a number of different currencies available. And this is again because the historical data for all of these currencies is within EA Studio from JFD. In this course, we're doing Euro USD, so we're going to keep it at Euro USD. And the period we're going to keep at H1. You can select all of the different time periods, but we are creating expert advisors on the 1 hour chart on the H1. You'll see that we have 37,000 bars and the date is from 2014 to current. The next thing we're going to do is go to strategy properties. Entry lots, here is where we can select our entry lots. I always keep it on 0.1 and this is my recommendation to you, especially if you're a beginner trader. Don't make it too big because you are going to amplify your risk too much. Stop loss, we have a number of options. We have always use, may use, or do not use. We're going to keep it on always use. Under type, there's fixed, trailing, fixed, or trailing, and we're going to keep it on fixed. Minimum pips, we're going to keep it at 10, and maximum pips, 100. Then for take profit, we're going to do very much the same thing. We have the options of always use, may use, or do not use, and we're going to keep it on always use. Minimum pips is going to be 10 and maximum pips is going to be 100. Then generator settings. So working minutes, here is where you would put the amount of time that you want your generator to run. I usually keep it between 300 and 600 minutes, so between 5 and 10 hours. If I'm going to let it run overnight, I'd put it at 600 minutes. But it is now morning and I wanted to generate strategies by this afternoon. So I'm going to put it on 300, which is 5 hours. Search best. So here again, there are a number of options. We're going to keep it on net balance. So basically what will happen is that the strategies that have produced the highest net balance will be first in our collection. Under out of sample, we're going to keep it on in sample. Max entry indicators is going to be 4 and max exit indicators we are going to leave at 2. Then generate strategies with preset indicators. If this is selected, just unselect it and ensure that the checkbox for use the common acceptance criteria is selected. We're then going to click on acceptance criteria and that will bring us to this page here. Now this is where we set the acceptance criteria for our generator and this is where we set the parameters that we want our generator to use when creating strategies. So what we're going to do is we're going to make our minimum count of trades 300. Minimum net profit and minimum R squared, we're actually going to get rid of. And how we do that is very easy. We just click on the red X. Then we're going to click on add acceptance criteria. And as you can see here, we have a lot of options available. And the one that we're going to use here is minimum profit factor. Here we're going to set this to 1.2. So what these two mean is minimum count of trades. What it means is that this strategy must be tested a minimum of 300 times over the historical data. And the minimum profit factor must be 1.2. So in other words, if we take all of our wins versus all of our losses, the profit factor needs to be 1.2. For in sample and out of sample, we're going to leave. We are not going to use that. Then from here, we're going to go back to our generator and we're going to click start. Now what you'll see is that it's calculating strategies very, very quickly. And as it finds strategies based on the acceptance criteria that we put in, it will put them into our collection. So we're going to let this run over the next 5 hours. And when we're done, we will have 100 strategies in order of the highest net balance over the time period. So the next step is that we're going to do exactly the same thing using the historical data from the rest of the brokers. Now, one of the great things about Expert Advisor Studio is that you can run multiple instances of the generator in different browser windows. So while this generator is running, we're going to open another browser window. We'll bring it across here and we're going to go to the generator. We're going to select the historical data from one of the other brokers. In this case, let's use IG Demo. If we then go and we look at our settings, they will all be saved. So all the settings will still be the same. If we go to acceptance criteria, you can see that the minimum count of trades is still 300 and the minimum profit factor is still 1.2. We then go to generator, we make sure that's on IG Demo and we press start. And as you can see, we now have two generators running, and I'm going to do exactly the same thing with the other two brokers. So in 5 hours, when all the generators have completed, I have 400 strategies in total. And from those 400s, we will filter them down to 10 each, which will give us a total of 40. And those 40 are the EAs that we are going to use on each of our brokers. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.